Hello, in this video, we will see how to make an iOS device a supervised device. Making a device supervised gives you enhanced capabilities so that you can control and enforce stricter policies on the device. To set up a device as a supervised device, you would require Apple Configurator 2 software, which is a free software that you can download from the Apple App Store on your Mac laptop or a Mac Mini. You would also need a Lightning USB cable, and you would require one iPad or iPhone so that you can test it. Now, once you connect the iPhone to your machine and launch Apple Configurator 2, you would see the device being displayed here. Now, once you see this device, you can go ahead and control it. The first step to do is by right-clicking on the frame. So once you right-click, you would see a menu with various options. One of the options would be to click on Prepare. Let me go ahead and right-click on here. Now, select Prepare. Once you click on Prepare, you will be shown a dialog where you would be able to convert this device or enroll this into the device enrollment program and also make it supervised. For now, I will uncheck the option to add to device enrollment program. I'll leave the supervised check and the check to allow devices to pair with other computers and click on Next. Once you click on Next, you have an option to configure a server. What does this mean? This means you can not only make the device supervised, but also enroll it into the MDM server where you want this device to be enrolled to. The default option is to do not enroll in MDM. Let me select New Server and proceed ahead. Here, I would give a name, that is MobiLock Pro. I have an option to input an URL. Now, this URL, I'll go to the dashboard, go to the bulk enrollment option, click on the QR code, expand the QR code which I want to use, copy the URL, launch the Apple Configurator 2 back, copy back the URL and click on Next. This will do some validation. You will see the URLs of our server. At this point, you are seeing a pre-production server, but in production, you would see mobilog.in. So go ahead and click on Next. You'll be asked an Apple ID, but the Apple ID is optional. So, at this step, you can either choose to enter the Apple ID or click Skip. You can provide additional organization information that will be displayed on the device while it is being set up and enrolled into MDM. I'll just enter the organization name here and leave the other blanks. You can go ahead and add other information if you need to. Click on Next. At this point, you can choose a new supervisioning identity. A supervisioning identity is nothing but a sequence of steps that you can either choose to be shown during the device setup or choose to be skipped. I'll go ahead and say do not show any of the steps. Once I have selected that, I'll click on Prepare. At this point, the Apple Configurator 2 will ask you to enter the Mac machine password. I'll go ahead, enter it and click on Update Settings. Once done, it'll warn you that all the data on the device is going to be erased. So if you're sure and have backed up all the data, go ahead and click on Erase. Once you click on Erase, the device will start the erase procedure and start enrolling into the MDM server. It'll take around 5 to 6 minutes for this to happen. Once the device reboots, you will reach a screen where you can click on Setup Manually. You can choose the type of keyboard, click on Next. Once you click on Next, you need to give a Wi-Fi because you need to enroll it into the MDM server. I'll go ahead and choose the Wi-Fi that I have here locally set up. Let me go ahead and set up a Wi-Fi. I need to enter the password as well here. Once I have the password, I can click on Join. As you can see, it's directly showing you the remote management screen. At this point, you can choose Apply or Skip. Skip will just make the device supervised but will not enroll onto your dashboard. I'll go ahead and select Apply and click on Next. Once I click on Next, it will try and install the profile from the MobiLock dashboard. And if all goes well, it will complete the installation and will show you the screen. Click on Get Started. At this point, the device is enrolled and has started appearing on your dashboard. I'll just complete the dialogues on the device and then we'll move on to the dashboard to see if the device has started appearing there or not. At this point, you can navigate to the devices section on your dashboard click on devices, and here you would see the newly enrolled device. Click on that, and you can see in the supervised section that the device has become supervised. Now, using this procedure, you can convert as many devices into supervised, or easier, you can create a blueprint and then make multiple devices into supervised. Hope this video has helped you. Thank you.